It's a rainy and grungy day here at Muddy Hard Grass Field in Microhard, Washington. It's a perfect sloppy stage for some MFL football or a tribute to Woodstock 94. Today's matchup is going to be complete mayhem. The teams are taking the field. The Cardinal Sins go up against the Microhard Mutilators. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If you like your cocktail cold, your soup hot, and your steak still mooing, then you're going to love seeing mutants knocked cold, their brains turned into hot lava soup, and their bodies strewn about the field, lying still and barely moving. MFL Game Day is on the air.
You just made me hungry, Grim. I'm going to go get some extra crispy mutant finger strips.
Hey, get me a full slab of broken mutant ribs while you're there.
Hot one, hot two.
At the last second. Nifty move there. And Matt told me today, Bricks, he had to step up his game. Not only did he step up there, he blew up. Nice extra effort. Second down and five.
Hot one, hot two.
With a burst of speed.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last three plays. Talk about luck!
And it's first and ten. They run it for a yard. Second down and nine.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and ten. The ball to the player behind him.
It's one thing to blow a play, but to blow up on a play? Then it's the team. I should learn from this.
He's dead, you moron.
And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. So you can check dead ref off your mutant bingo card at home.
One down. It didn't take long.
First down and forever.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. Second down and nine. The ball into the defense, picking up seven. Third and two. First down. He was not going to drop that one. It looks like we've got a penalty here. first and two. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. Second down and five. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Turner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten. Just a berserker. You know, after last week's game, we're blowing up on Shitter. Critics said he should shut up or blow up. You know, two birds with one stone there, I suppose. And it's first and ten. Smack that one back in his face. Second down and 10. This guy's a brick show with the brain scrambler. And that'll bring up third and one. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
The drive was stalled, and here comes the field goal attempt. Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. Since when is that a penalty?
Since now, I guess, Grim.
If they don't pick it up, the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, they let the punt drop and it will be downed by the defense. And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. And the defense gives a... Oh, man, he just went off the... crazy train and murdered that guy. Gotta love it.
He should bite his head off for an encore, Grim.
Third down and, well, good luck. And he was steering a pick six but dropped the interception.
And it plays a defense schmuck.
Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he put all of his foot into that one. He's got the ball now, and he's going to try and score. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and ten.
Keep a good mutant down.
Oh, what a brutal hit. And it's first and ten. And the quarterback calls a perfect pass and a score.
Wow, this is just horrible to watch. It looks like he's malfunctioning. Someone help him.
He's just dancing, Bricks. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Second down and nine. See that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And a hard run there picks up the first down. The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Yeah, you don't.
Yeah, man, he's going to hit him now. Oh, yeah.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Microhard Corporation. They get it right every up.